हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। सो अगेन वेलकम टू क्लास 6 मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 13 सिमेट्री लेक्चर नंबर 2। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल रिकैप्चुलेट व्हाट एवर वी हैव डन इन आर लेक्चर नंबर 1, दैट इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ सिमेट्री। व्हाट इज सिमेट्री? इफ ए फिगर इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू coincident parts by a line, then the figure is called symmetrical about the line. If the figure is divided into two equal parts, or we can say if half part overlap the other half part, okay, then the figure is said to be symmetrical, and that line is known as the line of symmetry. After that we have done how to make symmetrical figures. First is by cutting and paper folding. What we have done in this, fold a piece of paper, cut out a shape based on the folding line, whatever shape you want. First of all, fold a piece of paper, then make a shape with pencil and then cut out of that. Unfold the paper, a design is obtained. The design so obtained is symmetrical. The next we have done by ink blot devils. Hope you have done this activity at your home. Spill a few drops of colored ink on the half side of the folded paper. This I have told you that what you have to do, you have to spill a few drops of colored ink on the half side of the folded paper. After that you have to press it and then open it. The resulting figure is symmetrical, and the line where you have folded the page, from where you have folded the paper, that line is called the line of symmetry. Third method that we have done is inked string pattern. What is there in inked string pattern? In this, you took some piece of string, dipped in a variety of colored ink, and then spread them on half side of the folded paper. Again, now press it and then open it. The resulting figure is symmetrical, and the folded line, that line is known as a line of symmetry. Then we have done symmetry of English letters. Some English letters have one line of symmetry, some have two, and some have more than two. Okay, there are three types of line of symmetry: vertically, that is the straight one, horizontal, sleeping one, or we can say both line of symmetry, means in which we have both vertically also and horizontal also. Now see, letters having horizontal line of symmetry, they are like B, C, D. I have written few, there are some more. Okay, letter B, C and D have horizontal line of symmetry. Vertical line of symmetry, letter A, M, U. These letters have vertical line of symmetry. And some letters have both line of symmetry, such as H, I and O. These letters have both line of symmetry. Now let's start with today's topic, symmetry of some figures. Yesterday we have done line of symmetry in English alphabets. Today we will do symmetry in some figures: line segment, angle, scale and triangle, isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle, parallelogram, rectangle, etc. Now see, first one is line segment. Line segment, you all know how to draw a line segment. Now see, a line segment has one line of symmetry. It has only one line of symmetry, that is known as the perpendicular bisector of the segment. What is perpendicular bisector? Perpendicular is making 90 degree angle, and bisector means divided into two equal parts. Bi means two. Okay, sector is the division. So a line segment has one line of symmetry which divide the given line segment into two equal parts. Okay, so that they will overlap on each other. In each case, the dotted line is the axis of symmetry, a line of symmetry. Okay. Second is angle. Now see in angle. An angle has also one line of symmetry. That is the bisector of the angle. See, I have drawn the angle. Okay. And that black dotted line is its line of symmetry, or we can say the bisector of the angle. As I told you, bisector means dividing into two equal half. Next is our scalen triangle. First of all, you must know what is scalen triangle. A scalen triangle is a triangle whose all the three sides are of different length. Okay, in scalen triangle, no two sides are equal. Okay, so it has no line of symmetry. A scalen triangle has no line of symmetry. You can see I have made one scalen triangle. Okay, we can't make any line of symmetry that the two half will overlap each other, that the half, one first half will totally equal to the second half. Okay, we can't make any such line. Next is isosceles triangle. What is isosceles triangle? Isosceles triangle is a triangle which have two sides equal. Okay, isosceles triangle has two sides equal in length. Now see, an isosceles triangle has one line of symmetry, that is the bisector line drawn between two equal sides, two equal sides ke beech mein. Okay, now see, I have drawn one isosceles triangle where I have put two dashes. That means two dash means that they are equal. Both the side two dash are there. These two sides are equal. And between these two sides, we will draw one bisector line. And that is the line of symmetry of an isosceles triangle. Next is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle is a triangle whose all the three sides are equal. Okay, so a triangle, equilateral triangle, has three line of symmetry. See, I have prepared one equilateral triangle. Okay, and how we will make from one vertex to the opposite side midpoint. When we join the vertex to the opposite side midpoint, that is the first line of symmetry. Remember it, line of symmetry always move through the midpoint of the side. Otherwise, it is not a line of symmetry. Next is parallelogram. A parallelogram has opposite sides equal and parallel. Okay, and it has no line of symmetry. Remember, parallelogram has no line of symmetry. Now see the rectangle. What is a rectangle? Properties of a rectangle, you know that in rectangle opposite sides are equal. Okay, and all the angles are also of 90 degree. Okay, so a rectangle has two line of symmetry. The line joining the midpoint of opposite sides, you can see the figure. Okay, rectangle does not have diagonally line of symmetry. We cannot join opposite vertices in rectangle as a line of symmetry. So it has two line of symmetry. Now next figure is rhombus. A rhombus also has two line of symmetry. the diagonals of the rhombus. Means when two opposite vertices are joined. That is a one line asymmetry. So we can join the two pair of opposite vertices. So in this way rhombus has two line of symmetry. Next figure is of square. A square has four line of symmetry. In square all the four sides are equal. Angles are also of 90 degree. So the line joining the midpoints of opposite sides. Two are these. Two line of symmetries we can make in this way as we made in rectangle. And two are diagonals. In a square, diagonals will also make the line of symmetry. We can fold them diagonally also. If we fold square diagonally, we can get two equal parts. So a square has four line of symmetry, one vertical, one horizontal, and two diagonally. Next is regular pentagon. Pentagon has five sides that you all know. And what is the meaning of regular? Regular word means that five sides, all the five sides are equal. So regular pentagon is a figure which have all five sides equal. So it has five line of symmetry. See the shape of regular pentagon. Five sides it has. All the five sides are equal. Okay. You can make this figure. You can check it out by making the cutout of a regular pentagon. Then fold it. Okay. And how you will fold? Take one vertex. Fold it from the one vertex. And the midpoint of the opposite side. Okay. So you can get the line of symmetry. In this way, fold the regular pentagon along with all the five vertices and the midpoint of the opposite side. Next figure is a regular hexagon. Same as pentagon has five sides and regular means all the four sides equal. Hexagon means six sides. Okay, hexagon is a figure which is made of six sides, six line segments, and if regular word is there, that means all the six sides are equal. So regular hexagon is a figure which has six equal sides and it has six line of symmetry. See the figure? Six line of symmetry I have made. Okay, this also you can draw. First of all, draw these figures on a paper. Okay, first all means all the sides must be equal, then only you will get the line of symmetry, otherwise not. So make these figures on paper, then make line of symmetry with the help of pencil only. Okay, and one more thing that you have to keep in mind, that these line of symmetry we will always make with the help of pencil, scale and dotted lines. Okay, so that it will look different from the line segment. Okay, so make it in on a piece of paper, make line of symmetry, then draw one more shape of the same size and make the cutout of that and check it by folding it. Then see that you have drawn whatever you have drawn with the pencil, is that same by the paper folding or not. Next is of circle. Next figure is circle. A circle has infinite number of line of symmetry. Many line of symmetry, as many as you want, you can make. Okay, so in this also you can draw a circle on a paper. Then fold it along its diameter and check that how many line of symmetry can you make. You can see that you can make infinite number of symmetry in circle. So what we have done today? Today we have done line of symmetry in various figures, line segment, angle, scalene triangle, isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle, parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, regular pentagon, regular hexagon and circle. Okay? Now see what is today's homework. Students, I am not giving you book exercise, that is exercise 13.2, because some students are not having book and there are some questions which you can do only in the book itself. Okay, otherwise it is difficult. So I have written extra questions here. One or two questions are from the book that I have written here only, and rest questions I have written from my side. Okay, so don't do from your NCERT exercise, do these questions as a homework. First question is, write the letter of words. New mathematics books have no line of symmetry in this word. New mathematics books, you have to see which letters have no line of symmetry. Second question, write the letters of words. Just look which have one line of symmetry. Now in this word just look, you have to find out the letters which have only one line of symmetry. You have to write down only those letters. Question number 3 is, can you draw a triangle which has a exactly one line of symmetry, exactly two line of symmetry, exactly three line of symmetry, no line of symmetry? So what you have to do in this, make the triangle also. Okay, suppose it is, just see the first part, exactly one line of symmetry. So exactly one line of symmetry is there in isosceles triangle. So make one isosceles triangle and draw its line of symmetry also. Okay, so in this way you have to do all the four parts. Now question number 4, see, this is very interesting and sort of activity. Draw the following shapes on paper and by paper folding find their line of symmetry and then paste the cutting of shapes in your notebook. Okay, if you have colored paper then it is very good. If you are not having color paper then you can use the plain paper also, plain white paper. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to cut the following shapes, that is scalene triangle, isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle, square, rectangle, circle and regular pentagon. Cut these shapes on paper. Okay, and then by paper folding you have to find out the line of symmetry. You will not draw with pencil, by paper folding you have to find out. So whenever you fold, whichever you are getting the line of symmetry by paper folding, make it a dark crease so that it is visible when you will paste it in your notebook, and paste that cutting, that cutout in your fair notebook. Now homework solution of exercise 13.1, lecture 1. First question was, list of 4 symmetrical objects from your house or school. It is board, duster, door, a pair of scissors, tabletop, etc. There are many more. So you have to write down any 4. You can write down the disk of a computer. Okay, there are many. Question number 2 is, for the given figure, which one is the mirror line, L1 or L2? I have not made the figure here, but the answer is L2. L2 is the mirror line of the given figure. Question number 3. Identify the shapes given below. Check whether they are symmetric or not. Draw the line of symmetry as well. You have to first of all identify the shapes and then you have to check whether they are symmetric or not, and then you have to draw the line of symmetry also. See the first figure. First figure is the figure of a lock in which we have one line of symmetry, that is a vertical one, vertical line. Second figure is of bucket, or you can say glass also. It also has one line of symmetry, that is vertical line of symmetry. figure number C. It has no line of symmetry and we cannot name even this figure. So it has no line of symmetry. It is not symmetrical. D part, the given figure is symmetric telephone in which vertical line L is called the line of symmetry. You can see this is a telephone, okay, and vertical L line is a line of symmetry. E, the given figure is symmetrical. Horizontal line L is called the line of symmetry. In this figure, horizontal line is a line of symmetry. F part is, the given figure is symmetrical. See, this is a pentagon. Vertical line L is called the line of symmetry. Pentagon, but this is not regular. Five sides are there, that's why it is a pentagon. Okay, that's why I am not using the word regular, because all the five sides are not equal. Okay, so if it is a regular pentagon, then it must have five line of symmetry, but it is only five sides. So it has only one line of symmetry, that is a vertical line. Question number fourth is, copy the following on a squared paper. What is a squared paper? A squared paper is what you would have in your maths notebook in earlier classes. You have used na boxes notebook, maths boxes notebook, that is a squared paper. Then complete them such that dotted line is a line of symmetry. Okay, so what you have to do in this, you will make half part which is given in your book from, you will copy that, okay, and with the help of that given half side, make other half side also, okay, by counting the number of boxes. That one box is towards right, so you will also move towards right in this way. Now see question number 5. In the given figure, L is the line of symmetry. Complete the diagram to make it symmetric. See, blue one is given to you, okay? And black line, black dotted line is the line of symmetry. And red line is that we have to prepare. Okay, so what you have to do, in the same way as the blue line diagram has made, I have made it with red line. First of all, we will make one slanting line, then one more small red vertical line. Now see, it is same as that of the upper portion. If you fold this line, this figure, from the black dotted line, you will get the two half overlapping. Okay? See question number 6 now. In the figure, L is the line of symmetry. Draw the image of the triangle and complete the diagram so that it becomes symmetric. Same as we have done in question number 5, in this also we will do. Okay, blue triangle is the given one which is given to you in the question, and red triangle is that which you have to make. Okay, so see how to make the figure. In this way you have to make it to make the figure symmetrical. Hope it is clear to you. Thank you.